Dear students, let us to continue current electricity in the combination of cells. So first one is two cells in series. See here, this one is the first cell having EMF E1 and its internal resistance R1, and second cell having internal resistance R2 and EMF is E2. It is the EMF of the second cell and its internal resistance is R. The negative terminal of the first cell is connecting to the positive terminal of the second cell, and this end-to-end connection is called combination of cells in series. Of series, the cells are connected in series. So across A and B, first cell, and B and C, second cell, across A and C is the effect of these two cells. That means we can call it as equivalent EMF and equivalent resistances are EQ. So the effect of these two gives the equivalent. Okay. So now we have already known the maximum current that can be drawn from the cell is that can from the cell is I maximum equal to E divided by R. And if you connect it to the external resistance R, then the terminal potential V equal to EMF minus current into internal resistance. Okay, so let us to take the use of that, and we can find the equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance. So now from this, the potential difference across A and B, VAB, is simply potential difference at A minus potential difference at B. And this potential difference is across the first cell. It means the terminal potential of the first cell. So this terminal potential of the first cell is EMF of the cell minus current into internal resistance. Similarly, the potential difference between B and C is potential difference across B and potential difference across C, and that is the terminal potential of second cell, that is I into R2. Okay, you can take this as R1. See, now two cells are in series means current is same. Remember, if two cells are in series or two resistors are in series, current is same in series. Okay? And potential difference is same if two cells or two resistances are in parallel. Okay? Similarly, from this cell we can write VAC. Okay? VAC as E equivalent minus current into R equivalent. VAC equal to E equivalent minus current into R equivalent. Now, see, now VAC means potential at A minus potential at C. Potential at A minus potential at C, potential difference. So potential at A minus potential at B, is it clear? Potential at A minus potential at B minus potential at C plus potential at B. So simply potential at B, we are adding and subtracting potential at B. See, from this VA minus VB is potential at A minus potential at B means potential across or potential difference between A and B. Simply we can write this as VA minus VB minus VC minus VB. VA minus VB is potential at A and B, that is VAB, and potential at C and B and C. Or you can use, or you can write like this. Let me write in A and B, or you can take like this minus VC as it is. So plus VB minus VC. So that we can write VAB. VAB plus VBC. VAB is the potential difference across A and B. VBC is the potential difference across B and C. Okay. So this one is VAC. See, now we have to use these in terms of EMF. VAC we can write E equivalent minus I into R equivalent equal to E1 minus I into R1 plus E2 minus I into R. Clear? So E equivalent minus I into R equivalent equal to E1 plus E2 minus I bracket R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2. See, now this one is the EMF and this one is also EMF. Current is there, current is there, minus sign is there. So R equal resistance, resistance. So by equating this equation, this implies E equivalent equal to E1 plus E2 and R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2. So it means when two cells are in series, connected in series, then the equivalent EMF is sum of the individual EMFs and R equivalent is sum of its internal resistance. Okay, note on this. Hello dear students, let us to discuss two cells are in parallel. This figure shows two cells which are connected in parallel. So the terminal of the first cell connecting to the A and B, and positive and negative terminal of the second cell is also connecting to the same point A and B. So the potential difference across A and B is same for first cell and second cell. So the effect of these two gives across A and B. Okay. Now let the potential difference between A1 and A2, potential difference between A1 and A2, we can calculate as same relation E minus I into R. Okay, from this the potential difference across A1 and A2 is same as A and B, is same as B1, B2. Let the common potential is, we can call it as V. Okay, V equal to V. So from this we can write the current I1, the current I1 equal to E1 minus V divided by R1. We can call this as 1. Similarly, V1, V2 means potential difference across second cell or the terminal potential of the second cell is EMF of the cell minus current into resistance. But the potential difference is V. Okay? Whatever may be the potential difference across first cell, we are getting the same potential difference. Let the common potential difference, we can call it as V only. So, from this equation, we can write the current I2 as E2 minus V divided by R2. Similarly, we can write the potential difference between A and B is equivalent EMF minus current into equivalent resistance. So from this we can write the current I as, see, this one is also V, this one is also V, V. This one is also same, having the same potential, we can call this as V. From this we can write the current I equal to E equivalent minus V divided by R equivalent. Okay. See, at the point A, current I1 and I2 are entering and current leaving from this point is I. So we write or we know that the current I is the sum of these two. Okay. This flow plus this flow equal to net flow. Okay. So now we can substitute this from equation number 1, 2, 3. We can write E equivalent minus V divided by R equivalent equal to E1 minus V divided by R. Okay. E1 minus okay this equivalent EMF minus V divided by R equivalent I1, we can write E1 minus V divided by R1 plus E2 minus V divided by R2. This we can write E equivalent by R equivalent minus V divided by R equivalent. This we can write E1 by R1 minus V by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus V by R2. Okay. From this, E equivalent by R equivalent minus V into 1 upon R equivalent equal to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 minus V decade 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Okay. So now just you have to equate both sides. EMF by resistance, EMF by resistance. So this implies E equivalent by R equivalent is E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 and 1 upon R equivalent is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So this is the final expression getting when two cells which are connected in parallel. Only you have to remember, in parallel the potential is same, potential difference is same across first cell, second cell, currents are I1, I2, and in case of series, current is same I, but the potential difference as V1, V2. Clear? So, therefore, here you have to use current I equal to I1 plus I2, and here the net potential is potential difference across first cell and potential difference across second cell. Okay? So, only if you remember these two simple terms, so easily we can derive two cells which are connected in series and two cells which are connected in parallel. Okay? No doubt. Clear? Okay. Thank you.